How are we doing, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Coach Matt coming at you. I did not get to give a shout out to any of the female baseball personnel. And today, the Oakland Athletics have signed Amelia Schimmel to be the first female in the Oakland Athletics history for a PA announcer. She will join Rennell Brooks Moon of the San Francisco Giants and Marisol Castro of the New York Mets as the only female PA announcers in the major leagues. This game is bigger than all of us, and it is not a place where it is to be limited by your gender. So, that being said, congrats to Amelia Schimmel to becoming the first PA announcer for the Oakland Athletics, and that we now have three in the major leagues. And without further ado, let's get to the video. Welcome back to the Daily Baseball Report. I'm Coach Matt, and I'm here. I want to make sure that you all know that I want to provide you with the best and most up-to-date baseball news and baseball coverage for the major leagues, as well as anything that revolves around baseball. We are on the road to 1K by opening day, so please hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you know when my videos come out, and smash the like button because it really helps the YouTube algorithm. To get things started, I want to show you this pitch. In an era of spin rate, where we are looking to find ways to increase spin rate, my old friend from high school, Mickey Janis, he's still the only pitcher in all of my high school and college career to strike me out two times in one game. That has only happened once in my life, and it was to Mickey Janis. Just one of those situations. I'm just very fortunate to have played with him, and to this date, he is the only pitcher to strike me out twice in one game. He is a pitcher who is going for the zero spin rate, and it's awesome. What a great shot this was for a knuckleball. So you can kind of see, for those of you who don't know what a knuckleball is, it's where you grip the ball with your fingernails, and when you throw the ball, it just kind of floats, and sometimes it'll dance based on the humidity and the wind, and elevation kind of plays a role too, domes versus stadiums, etc. So it's just, it's cool to see that he was able to throw a ball and just nice and easy all the way in there. Great shot. We're going to first talk a little bit about injuries. We've had a few, and the first one is about a player who has overcome an injury, and the way the Major League Baseball article put it, it made him seem out to be kind of a hero, and I wanted to discuss this a little bit. Clint Frazier of the New York Yankees had a concussion. It was very obvious that he was concussed. He said the very next day he was sensitive to light. He could barely remember his cat's names. He did not want to drive to the stadium. His depth perception was an issue, and he hid it from everybody. He didn't tell his trainers. He didn't tell his coach. He didn't tell any of his teammates. He didn't tell anybody. That is a problem. He did get the treatment he needed, and he is healthy now. And I'm very happy that he's healthy now, but that is a very serious issue. I don't think people realize how serious that is. If you as an athlete are injured, you must tell somebody, because it'll be better for all people involved. No, you're not going to get cut from a team because of an injury. No, you're not going to lose your spot because of an injury. That is not how things work nowadays. Be smart. If you have any sort of injury, you must tell somebody. Now, that being said, I am happy that Clint Frazier is back on the field, being a very good outfielder for the Yankees. Awesome. I'm glad that he is back. I just have to get it off my chest as a professional in the field of strength conditioning. That is a very serious thing. George Springer of the Toronto Blue Jays sat out today's game because he had tightness in his abdominal area. The article said it was just as a precaution, but regardless, him having a little bit of stiffness is not a good sign, especially this early into the season. Ozzie Albies was also stretched from his game because he had stiffness in his neck. The one is sort of a HIPAA violation because they have disclosed Pedro Baez as positive for the current illness. There are 8 other pitchers on the Houston Astros who are now under quarantine because of the positive result of Pedro Baez. I hope Pedro Baez has a quick recovery and that is very mild or no symptoms at all, and that he gets back to the field as soon as possible. He was a really awesome relief pitcher for the Los Angeles Dodgers for many years, and I wish him the best. Speaking of the illness situation, Franmil Reyes and Jose Ramirez gave a public apology to the team today. A good gesture, but still, they still violated team policy. I still feel like they should be punished, whether that be a suspension or no pay or both. I still think that that needs to happen. Maybe 10 games, you know, something pretty light, but enough to get them to kind of raise an eyebrow. With the second violation with Franmil Reyes, he should have a little bit of a harsher punishment, maybe 25 games or 20 games. Put in the comments below what you think the punishment should be. I think Jose Ramirez should have a 10-game suspension, no pay, and Franmil Reyes should have a 25-game suspension, no pay. Zack Britton of the New York Yankees is going to have surgery to have a bone spur removed out of his elbow. He was having some soreness and discomfort in his elbow while finishing up a bullpen session the other day, and he did get an opinion and a second opinion, and it is definitely bone spur. So he will have the loose bodies removed. Moving on to actual games. Now that we've completed all of the base work there, it is now moving on to the games that has happened. I talked about this guy the other day. You'll see that video here. I will link it here. Heliot Ramos of the San Francisco Giants hit 2 home runs a couple days ago, and he just hit another home run today. I really can't wait to see him against the Dodgers. I really can't wait. And we all know the Dodgers-Giants rivalry is the best rivalry. Fight me on it in the comment section below. And I would love to see the Giants be very competitive. And Heliot Ramos looks like he is going to be the next Pablo Sandoval. And it would be really cool to have another player as electric as that. On the Brewers, Christian Yelich broke out of his shell today and had a home run. If the Brewers have 2018 and 2019 Christian Yelich back, watch out. The Brewers are going to be dangerous again. Real quick with the Kansas City Royals, what has happened with Danny Duffy? You Royals fans down in the comment section below, please tell me what is going on with Danny Duffy. I feel that he has been up and down for the better part of his career, but for the most part, more so recently. He used to be lights out. Blake Snell pitched again for the San Diego Padres today, and he had 2 innings. Give up 1 hit, 1 strikeout, and his ERA is still 0. He's still got a perfect ERA. And Manny Machado hit a double and a triple. He went 2-for-2 with a walk. And he's hitting .400 with a 1.138 on base percentage. Michael Kopech made his return to the mound with the Chicago White Sox today. He was blazing 98 miles per hour in his debut with the White Sox. It's been over 18 months. He had Tommy John surgery and then sat out of the 2020 season. So it's been some time for him. As we talk about the Chicago White Sox, ever since I praised them for being one of the better teams, third best team in the American League, I'll link that video right here. They have literally frozen. Their offense has frozen and they've lost the last 3 games in a row. I hope the Chicago White Sox could figure it out. Every time I do this, it happens every time. If I start liking some other team, they all of a sudden get ice cold. Speaking of ice cold, the Atlanta Braves only got 1 hit today. 1 hit, and they lost 10-1. Joey Gallo, do I need to see what it would say what he did? Yeah, he hit his 5th home run. Guy leads the spring training with 5 home runs. Speaking of home runs, Matt Chapman hit his 2nd home run of the spring with the Oakland Athletics, a blast off of Craig Kimbrell, which, by the way, Cubs fans, what in the world is going on with Craig Kimbrell? I've already asked this before. What's going on with him? Guy is like just serving up home runs, serving up runs to everybody. Joc Pederson hit another home run. It's his 3rd home run of the spring, and he kind of threw a little shade at the Dodgers, just a little bit. He said that he didn't appreciate or think that he was being used appropriately in defensive situations or offensive analytics situations. And I completely understand that side of things because the game of baseball has become all about the analytics. What are an insert stat and move player to be in the best position to perform. And I understand there's definitely a probability with all of everything. And he may be a little bit like, hey, I wasn't used to the best of my abilities. But that's what you have to say as a confident player. Like, if you're being platooned and he was being platooned with AJ Pollock, that's what's going to happen. They are like, Peterson's going to hit against right-hand pitching. Pollock's going to hit against left-hand pitching. They're going to move the players to their defensive orientation based on the hitter and the pitcher. And that's that. That's the final. So I understand Joc Pederson's comments. I don't think it's like throwing shades per se. It's just he wants to play. And who wouldn't? If you're a Major League Baseball player, why wouldn't you want to be on the bench? You would want to be on the field all the time. So I understand what he meant. It wasn't all too bad. The other Cubs hitter, Rafael Ortega, hit a walk-off grand slam. Just imagine if this was like Game 7 of the World Series.
Rafael Ortega will hit here. Bases loaded, one out. We're in the bottom of the seventh. And the A's on top of the Cubs, 8-5. That's hammered. Right field. Way back. Ball game. How about that? Rafael Ortega. The walk-off grand slam in the seventh. And the Cubs come all the way back. 9-8. Yes. Ain't it great?
That would be bliss. First off, hitting a grand slam is awesome. And doing it to walk off a game is awesome. But imagine this in like a playoff setting. Ooh, man. How can you not get romantic about baseball? Taijuan Walker made his New York Mets debut today. And it wasn't all that great. He pitched 2 innings. He gave up 2 hits, 2 runs. Both of those runs were earned. He had 2 walks and 2 strikeouts. Deuces wild, baby. ERA is 9. So, not the greatest first start, but it could have been worse. Steven Matz pitched for the Toronto Blue Jays, and Matz just needed to get away from New York, it looks like. He pitched 3 innings, had 1 hit, 3 strikeouts, and sports a 0 ERA. Is it Devi Garcia? Yankees fans, let me know. Is it Devi Garcia or is it Devi Garcia? How do you say that name? Do I say it right or am I saying it way wrong? Let me know in the comment section below. Going into the hat reference for the day. So this is an alternate hat. Gray top and the blue lid. And I got this hat at Dodger Stadium. I think there was a time when every time I went to Dodger Stadium, I bought a new hat. It was just, I was on a kick. And I think it was like 4 or 5 games in a couple of, it was like a 2-week span. I went to 4 or 5 games, got 4 or 5 different hats. This is one of them. Fits great. Love this hat. I've had it for, I don't know, 3 or 4 years now. And everyone needs an alternate hat, like the alternate batting practice hat. So why not? So there's your hat reference for the day. All right. And that will conclude the video for today. As a reminder, Sunday, March 14th, we are going to go live for the first time on YouTube at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time for all those on the West Coast. I'm excited. We're just going to have a great time talking about baseball, you know, what my vision is for how to provide you all with the best information that I can. I can't wait for the regular season to get started so I can get real into these coverage of every game because I want to be able to provide the best Major League Baseball content for all of you. So, that being said, please subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. And with all that, we will see you tomorrow.